Access denied. Access denied.
By getting my pit bull augmented. Get him some cyber paws, cyber fangs.
Grayson hooked me up with some real tight merch. Those Ugg lovers get in my face now, I'm ready to pop.
Grayson, where are you?
Hello there. Well, you must be Adam Jensen.
A keen observation.
Mrs. Reed told me you might pay me a visit. And don't take this the wrong way, but you're kind of hard to miss.
I'll try to take that as a compliment. She told me you might have information regarding Megan Reed's case and the attack on Seraph headquarters.
Oh boy, what a mess. Total pissing match. We had the feds on our ass, orders from three different departments, and pressure from so many lobbyists it felt like being the scrawny new kid in the prison shower.
It is a very high-profile case. Mrs. Reed said you thought some procedures were overlooked.
You got that right. I mean, you know how it is. Mrs. Reed told me you used to be a cop. There's always cases where you see the lazy officers taking shortcuts. But this was different.
Different how?
Too much stuff got overlooked. People seemed way too eager to jump to conclusions, and every time I was remotely insistent, I got turned down by ranking officers. People wanted to bury this thing fast. That's never a good sign.
Surely you have something more substantial than this.
Yeah, well, that's where you come in. I got a couple of leads I could never fully investigate. I started poking around, but these government-type agents just gave me the creeps. I got scared. Months away from retirement, I didn't want to fuck things up. But you obviously have the means to get to the bottom of this.
So what have you got?
First off, there's a rumor that the order to close the investigation came from higher up, maybe even outside the local department. Anything like that would have passed through Captain Penn. There might be traces of this left on his office computer.
Guess I'll have to pay a visit to the local precinct.
Yeah, well, while you're there. There was an officer assigned to the case, Chet Wagner. He's not what you call a choir boy. And when he suddenly got brought on the case, I got suspicious. Somebody wanted him there. And I'm pretty sure he tampered with some of the evidence. You should talk to him. Find out what he knows.
Okay, I'll have a little chat with Officer Wagner.
You'll most likely find him in the lobby. He got retrograded from his conduct, and he takes depositions now. He won't budge easily, but I'm pretty sure you can find some dirt on him on his desktop. His office is on the third floor. He might find something there to help loosen up his tongue.
Anything else worth looking into?
Yeah, when the order came down to close the case, the bulk of the evidence was stashed in a storage locker. Maybe you can find some interesting stuff in there. It's on the alley right next to the station. The code is 40-4891. But I know an outside agency had access to that locker, so be careful.
Thanks for the heads up.
Bah, it's nothing. And, please, don't bother coming back here with details. Don't get me wrong, I'm glad to help. But the less I know about this case, the better I'll feel.
That's all I need for now.
Access granted.
Would you say the police were overly violent?
Overly violent?
Will you be purchasing anything today? Always a pleasure, sir.
Back again to Detroit, where a handful of people were taken into custody this evening following yet another anti-augmentation demonstration.
Yeah? What do you want?
Information.
Then go bother the receptionist, Chrome Boy, instead of wasting my goddamn time.
Not that kind of information. I want to know about the Seraph Industries case.
Ha ha! And I want a blowjob and a vintage 05 Bard GT, so I guess we both keep on dreaming. Huh, Metalhead?
I know you handled the critical evidence linked to the case, and I want to know about it.
First off, I don't know what the fuck you're talking about. And second, even if I did, what makes you think I give a shit about what you want? Now, I strongly suggest you take your high-tech, toaster-looking ass out of my way before I handle you. Are you deaf or just...
Hello?
Speaking from the tarmac at Wayne County Airport...
William Taggart, celebrity author.
Thank you.
Routing that hostage situation in Detroit to the arrival of Williams.
Are you supposed to be here, sir? I thought the station had been locked down.
Thanks to the arrival of William Taggart, celebrity author and founder of the anti-augmentation organization, Humanity Front.
An extremely regrettable affair. I'd very much like to meet with David.
Thank you.
Access granted.
Thank you.
Back again to Detroit.
Access granted.
I'm trying to remind people that the only way they can get in touch with me is by online interactive streaming. Well, streaming will answer your questions. But don't get your panties in a bunch if you get hung up. We detect even the slightest suspicious fluctuation in signal. We have to shut you down. The World Order and their team of expert hackers could be trying to track us. And that's why we have to create a covert host site for every new stream and then shut it down immediately once the call's over. I'm sitting here. Just me and my techie Steve in a sweaty, clammy, claustrophobic van, tossing digipads out in the trash left and right in order to bring you this show via satellite. But I'm good with it. I'm good with it because I understand the reality of living in a slave state. You can bet they'll keep trying to shut us down, but I won't stop, followers. I will not stop until there is a full-scale revolt in progress. You hear what I'm saying?
Access granted.
Thank you.
people that the only way they can get in touch with me is by online interactive streaming. We'll stream you through and answer your questions as best we can, but don't get your panties in a bunch if you get hung up on. If we detect even the slightest suspicious fluctuation in signal, we have to shut you down. The World Order and their team of expert hackers could be trying to track us. And that's why we have to create a covert host site for every new stream and then shut it down immediately once the call's over. I'm sitting here, just me and my techie Steve in a sweaty, clammy, claustrophobic van, tossing digipads out in the trash left and right in order to bring you this show via satellite. But I'm good with it. I'm good with it because I understand the reality of living in a slave state. You can bet they'll keep trying to shut us down, but I won't stop, followers. I will not stop until there is a full-scale revolt in progress. You hear what I'm saying, people? You okay, Steve?
back again to Detroit. Following you.
Access granted.
Are you deaf or just plain stupid? I told you I had to get the hell out of my way.
Strong words. You're a real poet. Tell me, is that how you plan to handle the judge when they prosecute you for perjury, possession, and intent to distribute?
What the hell are you babbling about, Chrome Boy?
Funny story. There's this guy, Blaine Lopez. Deals dope near City Airport. A real scumbag. You know him? Because I have a nice little chat record between him and you. So you want to go to jail? Or you want to tell me what I want to know?
How the hell do you... Shit, man. Now listen, I just did what was asked of me. I didn't have a choice.
Talk.
Okay, look. I just came in one morning and there was an email with my new assignment in it. Official business. But there were also specific instructions. I had to check out the lab for footage from an Intellicam. They told me to take it and leave it near a garbage can somewhere near the lake.
What was on it?
Well, it's not crystal clear, but mainly it shows the boys who attacked Seraph as they were breaching the labs. And it looked like they were bringing something in with them. Impossible to tell what.
Who asked you to do this?
You think I know? Orders are orders around here. They always come from above. And nobody asks questions. You just do what they say, and you hope you don't end up like Secretary Haas over there.
Rally prematurely and closed the Broadview tunnel.
taken into custody.
Have you found anything? Please, I've got to know what really happened to Megan.
I've investigated all of Detective Chase's leads. You were right. Something was off with Megan's case.
So, what did you find?
An officer assigned to the case was asked to get rid of a major piece of evidence. Footage from one of our intellicams showed fuzzy images of the attackers bringing something inside the labs.
What? What were they bringing in?
I don't know. But for someone higher up to want that evidence gone, it must have been important. I got my hand on a test report that confirms what was bothering Chase. The attackers used excessive measures to make bodies and equipment unidentifiable.
Oh my God, Megan. What do you make of this, Adam?
I don't know exactly. I guess the idea was to leave no traces, no DNA evidence that would link back to them. But it just seems a bit too convenient. There were only three people who got out of the labs alive. Me and two others. One died in the hospital a few days later. The second one, a lab tech, was ready to give a detailed description of what he saw. Funny thing is, by the time the investigators got to him, he couldn't remember a thing.
You sound like you don't believe that.
I don't. Not from the reports I've read. I think someone got to him first. Someone in the government, a man named Manderley, ordered that a specially appointed medical examiner perform the autopsy. He bypassed the local ME. Simply put, that's not a good sign.
It sure doesn't sound good. So what you're telling me is we couldn't find anything conclusive?
No, I'm sorry. But one thing's for sure. Somebody's been hard at work covering up and destroying evidence related to this case. Somebody with power, who wanted to erase anything that might have made the investigation linger. I'm sorry, Cassandra. I wish I had more tangible answers to give you.
It's all right, Adam. I'm sure you did all you could. At least now I know my instincts were right. And, do you know exactly how Megan died?
I read the reports. She didn't suffer, Cassandra. I can promise you that.
Thank you, Adam. It's not much, but it still brings me some comfort. I miss her so much.
Don't worry, Cassandra. This is not over. I don't know how or when, but I will get to the bottom of this.
I knew I was right to trust you, Adam. But please, be careful. It's strange. I thought knowing what really happened would make me feel better. But nothing will ever justify this. My daughter is gone, and I'll never get her back. I wish I could be sure she gets justice.
Trust me, she will.
Look at you, man. Another sucker who bought a bunch of crap.
Access granted.
Just cut me off?
Someone over there.
I see.
Jensen? What are you doing here?
I think you know why I'm here, Tyndall. I want Corella's security footage back.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I'm Seraph Industries' chief of security. I'm pretty sure I can find out about an edited security tape, so don't bullshit me.
Ah, shit. Listen, Jensen, I never wanted things to get this bad. I'm not a bad guy. I feel for Corella, I really do. But sometimes, for a good cause, you have to get your hands dirty.
Oh, there's a good cause now?
Oh, I see. You think I'm selling the stuff, right? I understand why this would seem like an obvious motive, especially to an ex-cop. But trust me, you shouldn't always take things at face value. I'm not selling the neuropazine, I'm giving it away.
Giving it away? To who?
To the people who need it. You think everyone gets augmented by choice? No. Shit happens. And then what? You're saddled with neuropazine injections for the rest of your life, and that shit costs money. But what choice do you have? Without the drug, you'll die. Rejection syndrome, crippling pain, that just ain't right. So I did the only decent thing to do. I stepped up.
I can respect that. But blackmail is still blackmail. Corella wants out, and I'm here to make sure he gets out.
Man, this whole thing is becoming way too much trouble. I've even got two local pushers on my back because they say my philanthropic actions are undercutting their profit.
That's not your only problem. A gun-toting client was waiting for you in your apartment earlier.
Really? In my apartment? Shit, the dealers probably sent him. Tell you what, I'll deal with the client later. You take care of the dealers, and the footage is yours.
Okay, I'll help you out. But you better not be playing me.
You give me way too much credit, Jensen. I'm a security tech, not a hardened mobster. The two pushers go by the name PG and BK. They hang out in the alley near the basketball court. Just make sure they never bother me again.
Deal.
You trying to scare me, Skinner? Cause you don't.
What the hell? You been reading the Super Spy Manual or something? Long coat? Check. Sunglasses? Check. Attitude? No doubt.
Look, I told you. If you want me to give you that security footage, you're going to have to get those pushers off my ass first.
I've taken care of the dealers. Now hand over the footage.
Thanks, Jensen. Listen, I know it's not something you did from the bottom of your heart, but still, you saved my ass. Here's your footage.
Listen, Tyndall, I know you're trying to do the right thing. But we have to do things by the book, or we'll just have chaos. I'll put you in contact with someone inside Seraph Industries. They may be able to get you neuropazine for those who need it.
Seriously? You'd really do that? Wow. I never would have expected this from you, Jensen. I really appreciate this. Tell Carell I'm sorry. Thanks, Jensen. I guess I misjudged you.
Did you get it yet? Adam, please. You have to get that security footage back.
I got the footage. You owe me one, Tim.
Yeah, you got that right, Jensen. I mean, thank you so much. This is my life I just got back. Listen, I got a hold of a weapon mod. It's not much, but I figured a guy in your line of work could use it.
Listen, I know you were trying to do a good thing, and I respect that. But you should do it through proper channels. Next time you might not get this lucky.
Yeah, you're right, Adam. I know you're right. Listen, thanks again.
boss. We need to talk.
Is something wrong?
I'm not sure. Did you set up a private access route to bypass the company firewall right before you hired me?
Did I what?
Pritchard said someone's been using it to access our system since before the first attack. The security measures he and I set in place never stopped them because we didn't even know the loophole existed.
Oh, I see. Frank's fixed that, though, right?
He has now. But he's wondering why you never mentioned it.
Frank's paranoid, Adam. You know that. Can a busy man forget things once in a while?
You streamed an awful lot of data through that portal, boss. Right before you brought me on board. Pritchard may be paranoid, but I gotta admit, I'm wondering what was in it too.
Yeah, as an ex-cop, I guess you would. But the important thing is you found the hole and plugged it. We're secure now. And the information you uncovered in that FEMA facility may actually help us track these guys. So let's just stay focused on what's important.
You went behind my back on this one, boss. With all due respect, you hired me to keep this place secure. But I can't do that if you are not 100% straight with me.
Why are you getting so defensive? All I'm saying is we should be looking forward, Adam, not back. Not telling you about that portal left us open to attack, fine. But to be fair, it was your job to find our weaknesses and protect us from them. I need troops I can rely on, and I thought you were one of them. I hired you. I trusted you. When a lot of other people said I shouldn't. You know, Frank wanted me to hire a private military outfit like Bell Tower Associates. Maybe I should have.
Boss, I think we're getting sidetracked here. If you want me to win this war for you, I need to know how badly we've been compromised. I need to know what was in that data stream, in case our enemies accessed it.
I see. I suppose they might have tried to do that. I just wonder if you're being a bit paranoid here, fixating on details that aren't critical. I mean, are you so shaken up by what happened 6 months ago, by your failure to make a difference then, that you can't roll with the punches anymore? Damn it, Adam! I brought you back in today because you have an immediate crisis to deal with. Questioning me about things that don't matter isn't going to bring Megan back. Adam, are we done here?
Boss, I never meant to imply. Look, I'll back off, if that's what you want. But when you start dragging Megan into this, it puts me on the defensive.
Then get over it. Shake it off and get back to doing your job. Megan was a valuable asset, Adam, in more ways than one. If she pointed me in a direction, I followed up on it. Now, if the data I stream goes public, it's likely to get embarrassing, but that's all. And it's the kind of embarrassment the shareholders pay me to deal with. So I don't need you wasting your time getting sidetracked. You understand? Thank you.
Boss, I'm sorry if you think this is a big waste of time. I just don't want to see anyone else getting hurt because of information I didn't have. But if you really believe this data can't hurt us, that it won't come back somehow and bite us in the ass, then I'll trust you.
I'm glad to hear that, Adam, because frankly, I was beginning to wonder. I've told you all you need to know on this subject, and we've got bigger fish to fry, so let's focus on them. Verita's waiting to take you to China. Let me know what you uncover.
Thank you.